there's never ever any dreams to like be rich and famous or be like some rock star or anything or live off it. Or we love playing music, and I would love Clover to go on until the day I die.
It's just something about the creation process of it. Like, this is yours, and this is your interpretation of your life. This is my life. I live in Kingston, you know. This is how it makes me feel. This is how I am on a daily basis. This is my 9-to-5.
All right, you ready? Go ahead. 2, 3.
Literally, it's a vacation, but it's a different type of vacation because you're still working. So you're loading the equipment every single day and just trying to find a place to sleep. And most of the time, you know, we're like under rested. We haven't slept a lot. We haven't eaten well, but it's like, you know, we still got to go out and do a good show. But it's like you live and breathe it for, you know, however long you're out on the road. You're just living and breathing music, which is kind of like, you know, I love to do it all the time.
After being in a band for so long and a lot of failed bands, we didn't really understand what it was like to be in a working band, because it was just all for fun. But once we started getting on better shows and we were more interested in the music, it became just a driving force to want to do more.
I mean, we've been a band now for about 6 or 7 years, and there's been times where, you know, we've been close to just saying, you know, we can't do it anymore just because we're beefing a lot. But then we've had other times when we're like best friends. So I think that dynamic is something that a lot of people don't really think about when they think of like, oh, you're in a band. They just think of chicks and drugs, sex and rock and roll. But it's like the whole aspect of being in a relationship with these other members.
I've known Steve since I've been 5 years old. So that's a long time. That's going on like 25 years now.
Steve's a super hard worker. He has his own metal fabricating business that he started. About, I don't even know how long ago it was, maybe about 10 years ago, but that takes up a lot of his time. But he's always working on, you know, all sorts of cool metal art projects.
He takes care of all the other odds and ends. You know, we have a band vehicle, and he stores it, he maintains it.
Steve's actually a guitarist turned drummer. Because of the lack of drummers, he actually picked up the drums, and he was like a natural at that. He's an awful guitar player, but he's a great drummer, so.
Mike is involved in a lot more than just the, you know, playing of the instrument. He's produces like pretty much all our music.
He's a good people person, and he, you know, he's good at networking with other bands and help putting shows together and all the stuff that, you know, goes with setting up a good show.
Anthony is definitely the driving force behind the riffs. He kind of brings stuff to the table.
Anthony's very introverted, likes to keep to himself a lot. He plays his guitar a lot, you know? Does a lot of gaming. He's really into beer. going to breweries and going trying different craft beer.
I think the thing that drew me to Clover when we were doing this contest, I was looking for bands, I was looking for stuff that just stood out in its own way. Maybe it was, you know, a little bit more raw, sort of a, more of like a band vibey energy. You know, those are the kind of bands I like to record. I do a lot of very clinical, modern production where some of the life gets taken out of things sometimes. So when I came into this contest, I wanted a band that just sounded sick as a band. Clover's this three-piece that's just like a crushing unit, and it was cool to hear a song and just immediately feel like the vibe and the energy from it without even thinking about any kind of production. So for me, I was like, oh, this is just great to begin with. I could just take this raw, awesome thing and then do my thing to it, and I think that the end result's gonna be awesome because of that.
We're excited to work with Will. We've never worked with an outside producer or engineer, so it's gonna be a lot different for us. But you know, a lot of what Will's done is sounds great. Everything else we've ever done, we've just done in our houses, we've done in garages, any place we can record, we've used that. So going to Rubber Tracks and using a state-of-the-art studio is definitely gonna be a lot different.
I love doing this promotion with Converse Rubber Tracks. We get to give really talented unsigned bands a shot. Who wouldn't necessarily have the opportunity or funds to record with somebody like Will Putney or Kurt Ballou. And at a studio like this, to come in, even if it's only for a couple of days and they're only going to record one or two or three tracks, to come in and just get that caliber of person and that caliber of facility.
We applied for it and really didn't hear anything. So we just thought it was just, you know, we didn't get it. And while this was all going on, we had just finished writing the song that we were recording, Aurora. And it was just kind of, the timing was kind of meant to be. Right as we were saying we wanted to record one track and try and get that song out as soon as possible is when we got the email. So it was perfect timing and we were just ecstatic about it.
You could hit the freeze live, mm-hmm. and then kill it when the chord changes.
Yep.
You know, by then it would be.
The approach to doing this track with Clover, I wanted to keep the live feel that I thought was really good about the band. So we just tracked it live. I put all three of the dudes in a room. They just played through the song, and I kept like those drum performances just off of what they had played together in the room. Once that was done, we had those takes, and we kind of went back in and retracked some stuff, cleaned it up a little bit. But like the intention of the raw, like live jam was preserved by doing it like that.
When the snare hits, maybe the riff might be cooler if it's. So. Yeah.
So what am I playing? Oh, I'm playing a little more, right?
You're strumming through it, yeah.
Okay, I'll try that.
My favorite part about producing bands is giving a band an identity that's unique to them. It's my favorite thing to do, whether I'm working with a singer or recording any kind of band from any genre, or I'm mixing a record, I'm always like, what's special about this band? Why does it react with people? And I look to take those unique traits and sort of spin it in a way where it's like, that's your thing and nobody else has that.
Better than I thought it was going to. The sound or the professionalism of Will or the studio in general, we've never experienced that, and it was a very welcome change to what we're used to doing. It was a great experience, and we feel it came out great.
Working with Will was awesome. It was great, you know, me doing all the producing for all of our other releases. It was great to work with someone outside of Clover and someone to really give us a lot of cool input and great ideas. Will really helped us a lot, I think, make this track one of the best songs, if not the best song we've ever done.